It doesn't matter if you call it core or capital R-T-T-T. Get your red pens up, because we're Common Core this way, baby.
What is Common Core?
The Common Core is a set of high-quality academic standards or learning goals that outline what a student should know and be able to do at the end of each grade. The standards were created to ensure that all students graduate from high school with the skills and knowledge necessary to succeed.
The Common Core actually places some higher expectations on our students, especially at a young age.
It's making us think on a higher level. The kids are working at a higher level. Technology has come into the classroom. We're using Chromebooks, we're using the Promethean board, and various games in the classroom to help promote some of the higher level thinking that the kids should have right now.
Common Core has changed the way that we do things as students because it has streamlined the children's learning in the classroom. There's a certain set of standards that we follow, and it changes from year to year. As teachers, it has upped the rigor in our classroom where we have to take time to make sure that our assessments are really asking higher level thinking questions.
Well, in reading, I think that it's made me focus on having the students support their ideas and arguments with evidence from whatever we're reading.
I think Common Core has helped teachers be on the same page, as opposed to everybody kind of like being everywhere and not all together. I think it helps when we know what is happening at Yoakum, and Steinhauer knows what we're doing, and then the junior high knows what those kids are learning. It kind of helps a seamless transition for the kids so that learning continues to grow. So I really think that Common Core has really helped kind of streamline education in a sense that all teachers now know what they should be, what the kids should have when they get them at a certain grade.
It's put forth a lot more emphasis on enduring understanding, so bringing more from year to year so we keep our knowledge moving along. It has also put more emphasis on cross-curricular, so we spend a lot more time connecting what we know in music to what we would do in social studies, to what we would do in language arts.
I've always collaborated with the teachers, and I think it's really good to have a lot of curriculum integration where we can integrate the subjects so that what they're learning in social studies or science or math, they can then come to the art class and incorporate that. So it saves me from having to introduce it because it's been introduced in their classroom. And they come and they're actually telling me what they've learned and implementing art skills to explore that.
The lessons are more student-directed than teacher-directed nowadays. You'll see much more interaction between the students than the teacher leading the conversation. They're directing the conversation to each other rather than me directing it to them.
The Common Core has allowed for me to have my children think in higher level questions. It has also allowed them to really think about how they can apply their knowledge instead of just memorizing their knowledge. They can use it then outside of school as well as inside of school.
It's really allowed the students to just think more critically and really focus on their work and broaden their horizons as of how they're academically going to analyze every situation.
We're stressing more academics so that the kids are gaining more reading, writing, and math skills at a faster pace than in the past.
It's definitely, we've increased the rigor in our instruction. We've developed higher level questioning for the students. We are required to do fewer topics in each subject, however they are more in-depth.
I think it's had a positive effect because it allows for, because the Common Core is really geared towards preparing students for the real world, I think it allows for more real world, critical thinking, problem solving tasks, which the students really find more enjoyable, more fun, because they're able to relate to it.
Well, previously, a lot of the kids were expected just to know things, memorize things. With the Common Core standards, the kids and teachers are expected to reach a new level. Kids are learning through exploring, through questioning. They're using a higher level of thinking, which enables them to learn better in the future.
We don't know what tomorrow's jobs will be, but we do know that the future depends on a strong workforce in which critical thinking and problem-solving skills can be applied in any context. Mastery of academic content is critical to a student's future success in college, career, and in life.
In all of our Maple Shade classrooms, we strive to develop in our students this mastery, as well as core competencies such as collaboration, digital literacy, critical thinking, and problem solving to help students thrive in today's world. This is the foundation of our 21st century classrooms.
Children learn in all different ways. Some children learn by seeing, by listening, by doing, by being involved. So when we're learning about the letter R and the sound it makes, we look at the R, we write the R, what sound does R make? And as you saw in my lesson, we were rolling to the sound of R. So it's just encompasses ways for all children to learn.
What are you learning in today's lesson?
The letter R.
Today's lesson was comparing and contrasting two different communities, a town and a country, and they are engaged because they're learning from each other.
What are you learning in today's lesson?
About countries and towns.
We're reading about like this book on a country mouse and a town mouse, so that might help us understand the meaning of a country and a town.
Today they were taping angles going on a scavenger hunt, and they were finding acute and obtuse and right angles all over the room.
I am learning how to identify rays, line segments, and lines.
How to identify right angles, obtuse angles, and acute angles.
Okay. I engage my students by being incredibly fun and offering dynamic music choices, and hopefully, and using modern and classical music to teach the concepts that we need to teach.
I'm learning about the types of music, like the types of music.
I do a lot of different things. I do partner work, I do individual work at their own levels, and I also do some group work. And when I do the group work, I try and make it so there's movement inside of it at the same time, so they're really involved in something they enjoy.
Learning to work together in small groups. We're learning about bats and other topics.
Our lesson was about communities today. We were introducing the community Maple Shade and how important it is that we love and respect our own community.
And what are you guys learning today in today's lesson?
About our community.
About our community.
Well, in today's lesson, we're actually working on writing skills, and we worked on how to write a complete sentence.
All right, what are you guys learning in today's lesson?
Writing about our friends.
Writing about our family.
The way students learn is definitely a student-centered approach to learning. So in the computer lab, it is giving them few directions and kind of letting them figure out the rest on their own.
Let's focus on what a 21st century learner looks like. 21st century learners at Maple Shade.
Learn in an environment that is flexible, adaptive, diverse, and that allows students to consider new ideas and new ways to solve complex problems.
Build their academic foundation in subjects like reading, writing, math, science, and social studies. They will understand key principles and procedures and draw on that knowledge to complete new tasks.
Explore the most important subject matter in greater depth.
Develop an academic mindset and have a strong belief in him or herself. They will trust their own abilities to persist and overcome obstacles. They will also learn from and support each other.
What are you learning in today's lesson?
We're learning about compound sentences and compound predicates.
About compound sentences and compound predicates. How to read by yourself with a really hard book.
Reading chapter books with five-finger rules.
Today we're learning about fractions in decimals and how they are 10 times greater in place value.
In converting fractions right here, we're writing about decimals. Where decimals are used, like, let's say, to understand, right there on the board, it says, to understand that numbers less than one can be written using decimal place values. And we're writing in the Chromebooks, and that's how I like to learn. That's how I do my thing now.
How do you learn best in school?
Usually by completing challenging assignments and collaborating with my classmates.
Listening and figure out stuff by myself.
Because we do great stuff, we help each other. We help each other and we do great writing.
Usually with a partner.
By playing.
By listening to your teacher and dad.
With partners or with a teacher.
Working in groups.
Learning by myself.
In groups.
In small groups. We work together as a class and do sheets.
By listening to the teacher.
By playing.
Well, with a partner.
Try to have people try to be partners with each other.
I pay attention a lot and I just focus on the teacher.
Working with partners.
By listening and watching the teacher do it.
Working in little groups with other children.
Mostly when I'm reading, doing homework, and doing little papers.
Mark, you can go.
I think I learn best when I'm doing homework, language arts, stuff like that, and math, because math is my favorite subject, so I'm thinking that might be my favorite way to learn.
For years, the academic progress of our nation's students has been stagnant, and we have lost ground to our international peers. Through the Common Core, we hope to reverse course and better prepare our kids for their futures.
Don't be concerned, just be aware. The steps we'll take are to prepare. We'll start with group analysis of standards and their consequence. We'll clarify what you should know and maximize the way you grow. We'll give you help along the way, because teachers come in core this
way. No matter where you are now, happy, puzzled, or down, you're on the right track, baby, we can surely avow. We can be cavalier, and we'll help you this year. We're on the right track, baby, you're supported. Yeah.
Hey, we're on the right track, baby. Come and baby, come and baby.